In this video, I'd like to take a look at the voting pattern in Fengshan District in Kaohsiung from 2018 to 2021. So this is a map of the Kaohsiung City Mayor election on November 24th, 2018. We can see that Han Kyi won most of the districts from Chen Chi-Mai that day. So to review what relative support rate is, RSR, it's the ballots for the current election for one side divided by the ballots from the previous election for that same side. For the purpose of this study, the previous election will always be the November 24th, 2018 election. This is due to the fact that this is the only election in Kaohsiung in recent years that was not rigged. So the numerical figure RSR can be interpreted simply this way. If it is less than 1, that means there is less support than last time for that side. If it is exactly 1, that means support is the same as last time. If it is more than 1, that means support increase from last time. Therefore, if the support rate in Kaohsiung shifted from KMT to DPP in recent years since the 2018 mayoral election, we should see a strong negative correlation between the two camps. When we look at the RSR graph, we can see when the slope is higher, this is due to ballot stuffing. The higher it is, the more ballot stuffing there is. In most areas in Taiwan, the positive correlation is due to the fact that there are more stuffed ballots than stolen ballots in the area. However, in other areas, the positive correlation is due to the fact that the number of stolen ballots against Han Kyi is greater than the number of stuffed ballots for Tsai Ing-wen. So let's take a look at the RSR graph for Kaohsiung. The KMT RSR is on the x-axis, and the DPP RSR is on the y-axis. Each dot represents an area or a li. On the right-hand side, these dots represent areas where there was too much ballot stuffing for Tsai Ing-wen and not enough ballot theft against Han Kyi. The dots on the left-hand side represent areas where there was too much ballot theft against Han Kyi and not enough ballot stuffing for Tsai Ing-wen to make up for it. Both of these types of situations will lead to a positive correlation. A strong positive correlation indicates deliberate election fraud by the election staff in those areas. So these are the results from the Central Election Commission for the November 24th, 2018 Kaohsiung City Mayor election. Han Kyi was the number one candidate, Chen Chi-Mai was the number two candidate. Here is the Excel spreadsheet of the results from Fengshan District. So the results in Fengshan District were Han Kyi 118,466 ballots, and Chen Chi-Mai 88,437 ballots. This can be classified as a deep blue district in Kaohsiung. So these are the results from the Central Election Commission for the January 11th, 2020 presidential election. Han Kyi was the number two candidate, Tsai Ing-wen was the number three candidate. Here's the Excel spreadsheet for Fengshan District. In Fengshan District, Han Kyi got 82,432 ballots. Tsai Ing-wen officially got 138,172 ballots. On January 11th, DPP support increased by 56.24% and KMT support decreased by only 30.42%, which is totally not reasonable. This would suggest a deep blue district in the 2018 mayoral election swinged to becoming a deep green district in the presidential election. This should have resulted in a strong negative correlation between the two sides. So in this Excel sheet, I put the number of ballots Han Kyi received in each area or li in the first column for the 2018 mayoral election. Then I put the number of ballots that he received officially in the January 11th, 2020 election. To get the KMT relative support rate in that area, I divided the number of ballots that he received on January 11th, 2020 by the number of ballots they received on November 24th, 2018. The numerical figure is in the D column, KMT RSR. You can see that all of his figures are below 1, except for number 17. In that area, Han Kyi's support rate increased by 41%. However, if you look towards the right, DPP support increased by 82%. This would suggest that the election staff forgot to steal the ballots in that area, probably because the number of voters was so low that they just didn't bother. However, this reveals deliberate fraud on the part of the election staff. It is completely unreasonable for the DPP support rate to increase by 80% while the KMT support rate increases by 40%. This is the second page for Fengshan District. So we can see that the DPP RSR rate in Fengshan District is often above 50%. And all the way up to 100%. This means that there was a massive amount of ballot stuffing that took place in Fengshan District. They overstuffed Tsai Ing-wen's ballots in this district. The positive correlation in Fengshan District is higher than it is in Kaohsiung overall. You can see that in all of Kaohsiung, the correlation isn't quite as high as it is in Fengshan District by itself. In case you're wondering, this dot right here is the area where KMT support increased by about 41%, but then DBP support increased by about 80%. So it doesn't fit along with all the other areas because they didn't bother stealing Hungary's ballots there. So Ms. Tsai, I'm afraid you're the 111 ballot rigging president. You're in good company with Chen Shui-bian and Annette Liu. Unfortunately, you might end up just like him one day.
是吗，市长？可不可以请市长回答？请市长回答。哎，市长，当然。我们现在的需求超过这个，好不好？谢谢。
什么意思？所以是你觉得现在有没有吗？
黄远，我们会把这个整个白纸黑字的缩点很快送给议会参考，好不好？
可不可以请市长就问题回答，不要这样子避重就轻。
因为似乎你所关注的焦点一直在大陆地区。那具体上要什么吗？当然是高雄要什么，高雄要发财呀，对不对？So
that was Fengshan District City Councilor Huang Jie giving Hungary a hard time. We can see here that she was very supportive of the recall action against Hungary on June 6. We'll have more on her recall later on. So after Hungary was illegally recalled from Kaohsiung after the election staff stuffed over 600,000 ballots, we had the by-election on August 15th. Chen Chi-mai got another chance to run for city mayor after losing to Hungary on November 24th, 2018. Wu Yizhen's ballot count I ignored for this study, and newcomer Li Meizhen did her best. So these are the official results of the August 15th, 2020 by-election in Kaohsiung. Chen Chi-mai was the number one candidate, and Li Meizhen of the KMT was the number three candidate. Here are the results for Fengshan District in the Excel spreadsheet. So the results in Fengshan District in the by-election were Li Meizhen 33,561, Chen Chi-mai 82,698. When compared to the 2018 Kaohsiung City election results, the correlation should be strongly negative between the two camps. So once again, I took the by-election result and divided it by the 2018 result, and I got the KMT and DPP RSRs. You can see that the KMT RSRs from top to bottom dropped considerably. The results on the surface of things look kind of puzzling because the DPP support rate is almost the same as last time, while the KMT support rate dropped by a lot. So this was the map for the 2018 November 24th election where Hungary won most of the districts. And this is what the map turned into on August 15th, 2020 in the by-election. Chen Chi-mai won the election convincingly. This greatest shift in the electorate should result in a very strong negative correlation. However, we can see here that there's a slight positive correlation, suggesting that there was ballot stuffing in the Kaohsiung by-election. Of course, this is only Fengshan District. Further analysis of all districts in Kaohsiung are needed to draw further conclusions about the August 15th by-election. We can see in this picture taken on August 15th that the first stack of ballots closest to us are for the number one candidate, Chen Chi-mai. Most of the ballots look like they do not have significant folds on them. The second pile is for the number two candidate. The third pile is for Li Meizhen of the KMT. Most of those ballots look like they have significant folds on them and were cast by actual voters. We can see that there are a significant number of ballots for number one candidate Chen Chi-mai that have mostly no folds on them, suggesting that they were stuffed.
什么时候改的？开票的时候怎么会不能录影呢？哎，你们要听吗？请问一下，开票的时候不能？啊？不是啊，但是选办法里面有那个啊，4点以后就可以了啊。 怎么会有这样规定呢？你先稍等一下，好不好？我们询问一下。好。 那个不是都说4点以后就可以开放那个监票？
是监票，但是他不能直播啦。哎，
不能，我没有直播，我只是就是监票而已。
监票录
影直播。
监票。
录影呢？
录影他是说避免啦，
哎，避免。
对对
对。可是我只是我没有直播，我只是用录在我的手机记录而已。
啊、
对对对。
Also, don't forget on the day of August 15th, a voter noticed that there was an apparent stamp on the number two candidate. It looked pre-stamped. It was like a watermark stamp like you see on currency. This would suggest that the Central Election Commission is preparing ballots for the election staff that have been pre-stamped in some way. The details of this alleged type of election fraud have yet to be verified. So while it is clear that there was election fraud that took place on August 15th, it does not necessarily suggest that Chen Qimai was not the winner. There is not enough statistical evidence to suggest that he actually lost the election. In all likelihood, the election staff simply stuffed more ballots in order to make his ballot total look higher. Observers noticed that there were even fewer voters on August 15th than there were on June 6th.
这次的罢免案真的是非常大的难关，岌岌可危。如果大家不出门投票的话，凤山就会少一席进步派的议员。
So finally, last but not least, we have Huang Jie's recall election on February 6th. Some people like to say that the Wang Hongyu recall election was successful. Therefore, there is no election fraud in Taiwan. This is absolutely untrue. The truth is that the Wang Hongyu recall election was the only real election in Taiwan for quite some time. By all indications, the Tsai administration did not want to protect this particular city councilor. They simply let him get recalled the normal way. However, this was not the case with Huang Jie. Taiwan publicly said that we need to 守住 her, that is, to protect her. So here's the Excel spreadsheet for the Huang Jie recall election. You can see listed there the agree and disagree ballots for all of the areas. So the official results for the Huang Jie recall election were 55,394 agree ballots to 65,258 disagree ballots. The minimum threshold was 72,892 ballots. Generally, those who support the politician or don't care do not participate in recall elections. Therefore, it is very strange that there are suddenly 65,258 disagree ballots in this recall election. In the recall election for Huang Guozhang on December 16, 2017, the number of agree ballots were 48,693 to 21,748. While there were more agree ballots, they did not pass the threshold of 63,888, which was one-fourth of the electorate. So the trend in recall elections is that the agree ballots are more than the disagree ballots. So if we treat the agree ballots as KMT support ballots, and we treat the disagree ballots as DPP support, I calculated the RSR for both sides again, and the correlation came out strongly positive. This suggests that there was widespread and systematic election fraud on February 6th in the Huangjia recall election. So in general, when there's a positive correlation, it's due to the fact that the number of stuffed ballots are greater than the number of stolen ballots. In this election, it means that the number of stuffed disagree ballots is greater than the number of stolen agree ballots. So to recap this video, on August 15th in the Kaohsiung by-election, we see a slight positive correlation suggesting that there was ballot stuffing on behalf of Chen Chih-mai, but we cannot conclude that he didn't win the election. However, on January 11th for the presidential election, we see a much stronger positive correlation suggesting very, very widespread ballot stuffing in Fengshan District, as well as ballot theft against Han Kuo-yu. We've already concluded, due to the positive correlation found in five of Taiwan's major cities, that Han Kuo-yu definitively won the 2020 presidential election. In comparison to the August 15th and January 11th election, the February 6th Huangjia recall election had the strongest positive correlation. Therefore, we can safely conclude that Huangjia was actually recalled on February 6th this year. So I'm sorry, Ms. Huangjia, but it appears that your 65,258 disagree ballots were mostly manufactured, and that there should also be far more agree ballots in your recall election. Definitely enough to reach the threshold of 72,892 ballots. While you officially were able to stay in office, the statistics say that you were actually recalled. As Donald Trump would say, you're fired. I'm afraid Han Kuo-yu wasn't actually recalled on June 6th last year, but you were actually recalled this year on February 6th.
每次你都说的都是道理。